This is Ted, the professor at Messiah College. This is a statement from his science department. Okay, he says there's no problem between science and religion. And look at his own college. Okay, I got two slides here. This first slide is not very bad. Nothing really objectionable here. It says, within biological sciences department, there is no single interpretation that all faculty would endorse, nor should this be surprising. Indeed, the college expects faculty to form their own positions thoughtfully and to communicate these to our students in appropriate ways. In this way, we can offer our students multiple models for relating science and faith, which parallels what we do in other academic disciplines. Now let me show you the killer. Part two. We believe it's especially important to do this with science, as it reflects a genuine, legitimate diversity of opinion within the Christian community, and better equips students to evaluate information that might not fit neatly into one particular model. College library holdings, which are extensive in the area of science and faith, include many representative examples of each major position found within the Christian community today. These would include young earth creation, often called scientific creationism, varieties of old earth creation, including progressive creation, continuous creation, and theistic evolution, or evolutionary creation, and intelligent design. Young earth creation here is called a genuine, legitimate diversity of opinion. I mean, this is, if you say it's in church, of course you can get away with this. But if you say it's in academic circles, this is a scandal. Young earth creationism, that the universe is 6,000 years old, it's just as bad as saying there's a flat earth. It's just as ridiculous. And this is not only tolerated, it's called a legitimate diversity of opinion. And old earth creationism also is, anti-evolution. It believes that humans were made in a special creation instead of descending from other animals. This is also a scientific fact taught in every university, state university. No state university teaches young earth creationism or old earth creationism in science. But here a Christian school does. Why does a Christian school do it? This is how Christianity harms science. They're teaching their kids this. So anyway,
and I think I'd like to start with the last point he was on about statement about teaching origins topics at Messiah College. Partly because I wrote that statement. I wrote it at the request of all of the science faculty at Messiah, and then they edited it a bit and they signed off on it. Every single one agreed with what this says. Okay, it's a collective statement that I drafted. And Bernie was trying to suggest here that the comment about our library holdings, that's what this sentence is about, right? It's about our library holdings. And it says that, and it's about these positions which are found in the community today, and there they are. And that's a statement of fact. That's what our library holdings are, and that's those positions are all found in the Christian community. I don't see anything objectionable there at all from what Bernie was trying to say. Bernie, I think you took that statement out of its context. So I don't think I need to respond further to that one. If you'd like to ask me about that later, you can. Next, I want to come back. You know, and I will say one more actually. In terms of teaching the views, I'm going to make a pretty fine distinction here that I think is very important to make. I don't teach students at Messiah College any one of those views, in that I don't tell them what to believe. I think they're smart enough to think for themselves, and that's what I want to do. I want my students to be like me in one respect. Not in what I believe the truth is, but in how I arrive at those conclusions. I want to clone the way I approach a question, not the conclusions that I reach. I respect their right to think differently than I think. And I would hope that's true of your faculty here at OSU as well. I teach about many of the views. I teach about all those views that you saw enumerated there. I just finished a unit where I taught about five different views held by Christians on these origins topics. And my students will often ask me afterward which ones I think are best, because I want to explain each view as if I were a proponent of it, so that my students understand it very well, and then they can reflect on this themselves and take together all the information they're being given. So that is how I approach things. And I think that's an appropriate way to do it. I think it's a better way to do it, fact that it's taught almost anywhere else. Now, as for Christian beliefs harming science,
So for questions, I guess, one thing I would like to talk a lot more about is the Messiahology, because I think that's a perfect example of how Christian beliefs are harming science. Because the university is supposed to be a place where kids are taught science, and I can expand on that a little bit on your statement. You made it sound like we have these things, there's these legitimate positions in the Christian community. We have a library where we offer all the positions, and you made it sound like in your classes you go over all the positions, but you don't really say what's right or wrong unless somebody asks you your opinion, and then you might. So if they don't ask, I guess they don't ever hear it. So it sounds like you'd be perfectly fine for Christians to come in to your class as a young earth creationist and leave as a young earth creationist, no problem. But for me, I would see that's a terrible waste of an education. Especially if you know they are young earth creationists. I mean, that's a huge major flaw of science, the science understanding they have. And here they just came in your class, and you have no problem with your conscience on that. I don't understand that.
I have no problem with my conscience, Bernie, letting students decide what they think for themselves. And it's not that I don't challenge students' positions. I challenge the position every student brings, whatever that position is. It's certainly true that over half of the students who come into my classes have a background where they grew up with young earth creationism as the view that they were taught. It's also going to be true that at Oregon State that a significant percentage of students have that same view when they come to Oregon State. It's not simply something isolated to Messiah College. But I teach students about each of these positions, and many of them tell me they've never heard of any of the other ones. Never heard any of the other ones. And likewise, students who've heard other views have almost always heard about young earth creationism because it's so much discussed about. But they might not have heard of two or three of the other ones I'm going to show. I want the students to understand that they are expected to evaluate a position on the basis of what else they know, including scientific evidence, which they're presented with. But when push comes to shove, I don't have the right, in my view, I don't have the right as a faculty member to impose my position on them and to expect them to leave Messiah College believing exactly what I believe. I think that's intellectually arrogant and indefensible. And there may be faculty members at many schools who do that. And I would say in the same context, it would be indefensible for them to do that.
Okay, can I ask you a clarifying question on that? So let's say, for example, a student comes into your classroom and you know they believe that the universe is 6,000 years old.
Okay.
And you know at the end of the term they leave with the same belief.
Yeah, some of them do.
Okay, and that doesn't bother your conscience at all.
No. Why should it bother my conscience?
Okay, so let me ask a similar question. What if they came in as a flat earther?
Yeah.
And they left your class as a flat earther? Would that bother you at all?
I'd probably be surprised by that. Bother in that sense. It hasn't happened yet.
Yeah, the reason why you'd be surprised is because the whole level of scientific education in America has risen to the point that nobody believes that anymore. But in academia, it's the same thing as far as the young universe. I mean, in academia, nobody seriously believes this, and yet...
Well, very few people seriously believe. I wouldn't say nobody.
I mean, of course, there's always outliers. I mean, because there's thousands of PhDs in anything, so you can always find one or two that are...
I've asked people about this, because you know I'm very well connected with scientists, Christian and otherwise, because of what I do and the amount of time I've been doing it. And those in a position to know, which means professional geologists who are Christians and even have their own organization called the Affiliation of Christian Geologists. I know from people in that organization, their own view, which is not measured by polling, but their view in terms of how many people they know that think what, would be that a low single-digit percentage of those Christian geologists they know think the Earth is not more than 10 or 12,000 years old. A low single-digit, somewhere 3, 4, maybe 5% at the most. So among Christian geologists, who are professional geologists, it's way under 10%. And it may be as low as 3%, who knows. But it's not very high. So So there are, but there are some people, it's not none, there are some people who believe that. Just as there are some scientists who are completely secular scientists who don't believe in Big Bang cosmology. There are some who still think that's not sufficiently evidenced. Mm-hmm. But it's not something that I focus on. Very, very few Christian scientists believe that. This is very, very few scientists in general believe that.
Well, you said the case is the same at OSU as it is at a psychologist, as far as a kid coming in with a understanding of the universe 6,000 years old and they're not really told how to think. Do you think it's the same thing here at OSU? And I can't imagine that. I think the only reason why it's tolerated at your school is because you're a Christian school, and this is how Christianity is hurting science. Here, if you write a paper in science class about how the universe is 6,000 years old, I'm sure you get an F on it.
What you mean by tolerated is where I would differ with you, in the sense that I respect the student and their right to sort out their own view of things. That's what I respect. And it's not that I tolerate the view. I tolerate many, 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 many views in that sense. It's that I respect the student's right to make that choice about what they think when this is done.
Yeah, but part of the problem is I think you're also respecting the position of the young earth creationism. For example, in your library, I'm assuming your library has books about young earth creationism and why it's legitimate. And you're not really having books about why it's wrong.
We have many, many books why it's wrong. Why would you infer that we wouldn't?
But you also have books of why it's true and promoted, right?
We have a number of books. So it's I don't know how many, so I can't put a number on it, but we do have books that argue for creationism.
So if you did a study in your library, do you think a person would come away with the idea that there's a neutral stance on it because there's like equal number of books on both sides, or do you think it's like mostly against?
No. Most of the works in our library have nothing to do with creationism, and those that do, a large majority of those books would not take a young earth creationist perspective. But we have young earth creationist books. Why should we not? Why should not OSU have young earth creationist books if there are people who want to study that subject? Wouldn't you read the people who write those books?
Not from proponents. I mean, because they're saying this is, it's pseudoscience is what it is.
It may be pseudoscience. I share your view in this case that it's pseudoscience. But shouldn't you have books about pseudoscience and pro-pseudoscience books in the OSU library if people want to study pseudoscience?
Maybe if it's taught as pseudoscience, yeah. I mean, you got to show this is why it's pseudoscience.
Do you have anything in your library by Emmanuel Velikovsky, for example, I wonder?
Never.
From the 1950s? Okay, yeah. I won't take that further. But there, he wasn't a creationist, he wasn't a Christian even. He was a Jewish author. But his books were seen as pseudoscience by people like Carl Sagan, back in the 1950s and 60s. He was a very popular author.
My main point here, and I'll let you have the last word on this, my main point is though that you're saying that Christianity is conducive to doing good science and maybe also informs science. And I'm saying your very college is an example about how Christian theology is harming science because the fact that you could have a young earther go there and not feel threatened or challenged or it wouldn't even bother you if they left that way. It seems like there's maybe a passion or understanding for science you don't have even.
Well, you just used two verbs that I'm gonna pick up on, threatened and challenged. If students come through my classes holding that view or any other view, they're going to be challenged unless they decide to come through class with their brain turned off, and then they're not gonna do very well. But the threatened is the word that I don't wanna use because I don't threaten students.
I don't mean physically threatened, but I mean threatened
the
ideas.
I don't want to threaten students and make them feel like the only conclusion they can possibly reach on this issue and not be stupid, uninformed, or wicked, to paraphrase Richard Dawkins, is the same conclusion that Richard Dawkins reaches. I don't want that to be the case. I don't think that's hospitable. I don't think that's respectful to the student is. Well, and I don't think you'd want me to treat you that way if you're one of my classes and you were a young earth creationist. I don't think you'd want me to treat you that way.
I want you to be blunt with me and tell me, I don't want you to play,
Well, can we talk about something else now?
Yeah,
let's talk about something else.
Say, let's,
um, uh, let's, uh,